I'm Ludwig Nussel. I'm a software engineer for SUSE, and I did most of the technical implementation so far of this project. So let me start with a scenario, something to think about. Suppose you run SUSE Linux Enterprise 12, and you want to have the IRC client SE running on it, because you want to connect to IRC and chat with people. What do you do? Enable all modules and add-ons you have there, search for SE, and it doesn't find it. So what are you going to do now? You have several options to get this software on your SUSE Linux Enterprise. For example, you go to build.opensuse.org, go to OpenSUSE 13.2, because that was a release that is close to the one when SLE 12 was released, and get the SE package from there. With some luck, it might actually work on SLE 12, because the code base is similar enough. But you fetch only this single package, and you won't get any updates from it. So if the package maintainer decides that he wants to fix some bug or there's a security issue, you would have to go again to the download server and download the package manually. So it's not really a convenient option. Another option would be to go to build.opensuse.org again, or to download OpenSUSE.org, search for SE there, and again, with some luck, you will find some packages that have packaged SE for SUSE Linux Enterprise 12, maybe in the home repo, maybe in some devil project. You could add that repo, then at least you get updates for that, but you don't know the quality of the package. I mean, in a home repo, there are no rules. You don't know what the package maintainer of this package intended with this package. So maybe it's some experimental version of this SE IRC client. Maybe it requires some extra libraries. Maybe some that actually are not compatible with the ones on SLE, like it could require a new OpenSSL, who knows. So not on the safe side either. So the last resort would be you go to the SE website, download the sources, and compile them yourself. And at least you know for sure what's inside. But you have to do this for every new version of SE again. You don't have package management for that, so you bypass all the install and uninstall rules. In other words, it sucks. This is not the, there's no good way to get SE for SUSE Linux Enterprise. But then we have OpenSUSE there, so let's take a quick look. What's the difference between what we have, SUSE Linux Enterprise 12, and OpenSUSE? SUSE Linux Enterprise 12 consists of about 3,000 source packages. That includes all the base system, the add-ons, and also some products that are not generally available. On the other hand, OpenSUSE has the 13.2, the last release, has 7,500 roundabout, and Tumbleweed, meanwhile, has 8,000. The number is growing. So there's a huge number of packages already out there in the OpenSUSE ecosystem that is quite similar to SLE, because SLE is a similar code base. A reason why there are so little packages in SLE is that SUSE provides maintenance and support for that. So in SUSE Linux Enterprise, you only find packages where SUSE has engineers that know about the software and can provide you with maintenance updates, bug fixes, security updates. Whereas in OpenSUSE, most packages are maintained by the community. So you can basically find anything in there. There's no promise that you get maintenance for that. Maintenance means patches. So if there's a bug, you get a bug fix, not a new version update. That's why I wrote no here for Tumbleweed for maintenance, because Tumbleweed is mostly you get a new version from upstream and get a version update. That means new features, but maybe also regressions or incompatibilities. Support means you can call SUSE, and they will fix the bug for you, probably just for you. That's what you only get for SUSE Linux Enterprise, not for any of the OpenSUSE options. But for SLES, you get a lifespan of about 10 years, probably even more. So you have a stable base for a very long period of time. OpenSUSE releases, on the other hand, are maintained for about 2 years, 18 months, something like that. Lifetime doesn't really apply to Tumbleweed, because it gets updated daily, always fresh. So we have all this beautiful software here in OpenSUSE, we want that also for SUSE Linux Enterprise. So what would be our wish list for getting extra software on SUSE Linux Enterprise? We want to benefit from what we already have in OpenSUSE. On the other hand, maybe OpenSUSE can also benefit from what SUSE Linux Enterprise people want in SLE. There are probably people that are already using the build service to build packages for SUSE Linux Enterprise only. It would be nice to have them in Tumbleweed. In return, they get other software that is already in Tumbleweed. For having extra software, we want one repository. Right now, the OpenSUSE build service has tons of repos, but you don't know the rules in those repos. You have to search for it. You have to manually add them. That is not practical. If you come from OpenSUSE, you know, just zip in anything, and it basically has it. That's what we also want for SUSE Linux Enterprise. Installing packages from such repos should be safe. When you fetch something from the build service, you do not know the rules, as I said. Maybe it draws in extra libraries. If you want something that should be easy to use on SLES, it should avoid those pitfalls. It should be safe. You should not void your support contract just because you installed an IRC client and replaced your OpenSSL. That would be bad. And it would be nice for such a repo to have some level of maintenance. So we do want bug fixes. Not the case that you fetch the package somewhere and it stays there forever. You do want to have package updates, maybe also security updates. So how can we do this? Some ideas. We use build.opensuse.org for that, of course, because that's where the OpenSUSE package maintainers are. There were ideas that someone could set up a separate build service and provide packages there, but it doesn't really scale. You have to configure a separate system then. So why not use build.opensuse.org and host something there? That makes it also really easy to submit packages from Factory or from Tumbleweed to this backport thing. That's how it's called, OpenSUSE backports. So it sounds like a natural thing for OpenSUSE to also offer something for SUSE Linux Enterprise. So let's put it in the OpenSUSE namespace, OpenSUSE backports. How can we avoid this conflicting packages? So how can we avoid that SE replaces OpenSSL? Well, we already have RPMLint. RPMLint runs at the end of every package build. It gets the binary RPMs produced and can look at the metadata there, can look at the content even. So we can compile a list of all packages contained in SLE, including their file lists, and have RPMLint compare build results with that one. And it can fail a build of a conflicting package right away. Okay. And how could we actually get packages into this OpenSUSE backports thing? There are basically two workflows that are used in the OpenSUSE ecosystem. That is the factory workflow and the maintenance workflow. In the factory workflow, you take the sources and submit them to OpenSUSE factory. Then the submission gets reviewed, accepted, checked in, and then the package builds in factory. Now, if the submission consisted of several packages that depend on each other, it could happen that one package gets checked in before the other, and so the package fails to build in factory, then you have to wait for the next check-in. So it's not guaranteed that the check-in process is actually atomic. It could also happen that something, a devil project, made the package build, but as soon as it's in factory, it fails. So that would be then the job of the factory maintainers to fix up the package or revert it. There's the factory workflow. And then we have the maintenance workflow that is used to provide OpenSUSE maintenance and security updates. For the packager, it looks similar. So you submit your package to the update project, but instead of a submit request, it's a maintenance request. And then maintenance takes your submission, puts the sources into a separate project that's called a maintenance incident, and the package gets built in there, including all packages that are together. So if you have a package with plugins, you would also put all the plugins in this incident project. The package gets built there. When it's all settled, the project gets locked and there's a release request. Now it can be tested by QA. If QA considers this combination of packages good, it can be released in the update project. That means not only copying the sources, but also copying the binaries, because you know those binaries are tested and can be released together, kind of atomic. So that sounds good for a backports project that wants to deliver packages to customers. And it avoids that you have to check this target repo all the time for build failures, because they're already filtered out in the maintenance incidents. And to get actual updates, we should involve the SUSE security team. So for OpenSUSE, they also monitor the packages for security issues, like they are subscribed to a full disclosure list or OSS security, and they file bug reports for maintainers. Would be nice to also have the service for backported packages to SUSE Linux Enterprise. To achieve all of this, we have to have some policies. So my proposal is to use the OpenSUSE packaging policies that are already there. They are used for the releases as well as for Tumbleweed, so they're good. Packages that adhere to this policy should be also good enough for SUSE Linux Enterprise. As a first start for this backports project, we only allow packages that are already in factory. That avoids double work on the review team. As there's the OpenSUSE review team and the legal team, for example. If we take packages from factory, we know that they're already reviewed and good, so we can just take them. Yeah, as I mentioned, there should be a rule that there are no conflicts with SUSE Linux Enterprise packages. In addition, OpenSUSE doesn't explicitly spell out that you are allowed to do version updates and maintenance updates, so most maintenance updates for OpenSUSE are actually just patches. But for this project, I propose to explicitly state that version updates are allowed, so you can take the package from factory again and just version update it, provided that the repo consistency is maintained, of course. So over time, that gets more difficult because SUSE Linux Enterprise is getting older, but it should be doable. And also not explicitly spelled out in OpenSUSE, but I wanted to say it here, is that some teams have a veto right. So for example, security can say a package is so bad, it requires really bad security binaries or opens weird ports. We don't want that in a repo that is offered for customers. So we want to have that option in this repo. Also legal, for example, might say that there's some weird license tag in it or proprietary components that we cannot ship. They should have a veto right to actually prevent the package from getting in, from getting updated, or even get it removed again. That's something that's not possible in OpenSUSE. We have the update channel at the moment, I think. But here it would be nice that if a package turns out really bad, we can just pull it. Okay, based on that, there's already an implementation in OBS. It uses the OpenSUSE Backports SLE 12 project. SLE 12 because that's pretty new, so it's close enough to factory that we can take packages from there without much trouble. It's x86-64 only at the moment, even though SLES supports more architectures. But the OpenSUSE community only has x86-64, so we cannot expect community packages to work on other architectures right now. So it starts with x86-64. The RPM lint checker I mentioned is implemented, so you cannot build a package against this repo that conflicts with SLE packages in any way. There's also a cron job running that regularly scans the SUSE Linux Enterprise update channel and updates this blacklist in the RPM lint check. There are some review bots, so if you submit a package to this backports repo, the review bot takes a look at the sources and checks if it is in factory, so it scans the history of factory and makes sure that your source revision is also in factory. And another bot makes sure that the package maintainer submitted the package. For factory, you cannot bypass the package maintainer because any submission has to go through the devil project. But for the maintenance workflow, there was a loophole, so anyone could actually submit maintenance updates. Now there's a review bot that makes sure that the the original package maintainer submitted the package, or he reviewed it. So make sure there was a review on the package that was accepted by the package maintainer. Otherwise, you cannot submit to this project. There are even some packages already there. So we have Chromium and Mumble, for example, for testing, thanks to Bernhard. The current state is considered better, I would say. I'm not sure about the workflow and all that, if that works out well. So testers and contributors are welcome. Please submit your packages there. Would be nice. But take it with a grain of salt if you add it to SLE. We kind of expect you that you know how to fix issues if you encounter some. Yeah, so how do you submit actually a package to this repo? Quite easy. Just branch the package from factory, or take the devil project if you're the original maintainer, add the OpenSUSE backports SLE 12 repo as build target. Then it will build against this repo, and the RPM then checks that the package is actually good for this repo, and then just submit it there. Even though it's a maintenance project, you can use the OSC submit request command. It will just do the maintenance request automatically. You don't have to worry about that. As I said, the source must be in factory. That's a precondition at the moment. So you need to branch from factory. That's the easiest way. How do you use it? If you want to test the packages in there, quite easy, just at the repo. For some packages, you may need to add some extra modules and add-ons. So you can just go to Yast and enable them. Because, for example, the web and scripting module has several Python modules or Ruby gems that might be needed for some packages there. And some desktop packages might need the SUSE Linux Enterprise desktop, actually. So you need to enable those if you want to use those packages. And then you can just super in. Great. But there's quite some work left to be done for the future. First of all, we need more packages to make this repo more attractive. For example, KDE would be really nice to have for SUSE Linux Enterprise. There's already work going on in the build service somewhere, but it doesn't fully build because KDE is really huge. So there are people working on resolving those issues, but volunteers welcome. Then another issue that we found recently is that we somehow need to weaken this requirement that the package must come from factory. Because, for example, Tumbleweed, now I'm doing the same mistake as Marcus this morning, Thunderbird has a regular release and an extended release. And on SUSE Linux Enterprise, Thunderbird and Firefox share a library, NSS. And Firefox is the extended release on SUSE Linux Enterprise. It would be nice to also use the Thunderbird ESR on this backports repo. But for factory, we don't use this extended release. So somehow, in such cases, we need to make an exception from this factory first rule. And to actually deliver the repo to customers, it would be really nice to have it in the SUSE Customer Center. So SUSE Linux Enterprise customers can enable on their machines with just a mouse click. That requires still some negotiations with SUSE. And something that OpenSUSE maintenance would benefit from would be OpenQA. So it would be really cool if we could test this Chromium update, for example, in OpenQA. Just run this maintenance issue through OpenQA and automatically determine if it's good or bad. That would be an area to work on. Another area would be maybe to think of whether to allow non-free packages. Right now, it's only free software allowed. But in case some proprietary company wants to sponsor something there, I guess we won't say no, maybe. Also, and that is something that I would personally also like to see, is a web interface for this. We have this nice download OpenSUSE.org and software OpenSUSE.org and build OpenSUSE.org, but we kind of lack a central package database or something that nicely summarizes which package is available for which distribution. So I would really love to see someone picking up the web interface task and make it easier to find packages. Yeah, that's it basically from my side. Any questions? see Frederick.
So two questions. First, do you think it would be a good idea to allow, in addition to branch package, maybe allowing submitting packages from released OpenSUSE version, like, for instance, you take a package which is too recent in Tumbleweed to be pushed to SLE 12, but the version in 13.2 would be enough?
Yeah, that might be actually the next best thing, because when the package is already released in an OpenSUSE update channel, we also know that it was reviewed by the review team. Yes, that would be an easy next step for that.
And another question, in the check, which are done in by RPM Lint, do you prevent that a package ships a library which could hide a library which is already shipped in SLE 12? Because that would be some way of breaking packages.
Yeah, you already found the trick.
Damn.
Yeah, we at the moment, the RPM Lint check only matches the file list. So yes, you could put a library in slash lib, where the SLE package has it in user lib, but I didn't want to say that.
Sorry.
But I already have an issue for that to fix it.
It seems that there should be some way of communicating what is actually wanted or needed by people, right? Some kind of poster board where people can go and say, and I would really like to have this package on SLE. I mean, if we now all go in and say, okay, we have 8,000 packages in Tumbleweed, and we're going to stick, what, just 3,000 in SLE, so that means now you're going to get a rush of 5,000 packages into backport, I don't think that's very useful. So I think it would be really great to have some way of people to post somewhere or send a request and say, I would like to have package X, and then the maintainer of that package gets a notification and can decide whether they want to do the work or not. Is that, have you thought about something like that?
Yes, I mean, the SUSE Linux Enterprise customers most likely, or the typical SUSE Linux Enterprise customers, probably not subscribe to the factory list, so they need to have some other channel. And as far as I know, that channel goes through product management, through Fate somehow. So we need a proxy in SUSE that takes those customer requests and turns them somehow in something the community can work with. So yeah, we need a proxy in SUSE that talks to the community on one side and to the customers on the other side. Yeah, Andreas had a question.
I wanted to know pretty much the same thing as Robert, like how this is, you know, humanly supposed to work as opposed to the technical side that you've already outlined, like who initiates these things and who is responsible for the individual steps.
Pardon? So could you take the mic? I don't understand.
I did? Okay, yeah. Sorry. So as a first step is who initiates this thing, and then, you know, like what is the complete picture. So are there, you know, like rules of packages that like should not be included in the backports? And
right now there is no rule that something cannot be included in backports. The only rule is that it must not conflict with packages in SLE by name or by file list or by libraries that will come. But apart from that, there's no rule. It must be in factory, so it must pass the OpenSUSE packaging guidelines and reviews.
I mean, your example was IRSI, which is like a standalone application, as I understand it. So this would not be intended for like having side-by-side versions of libraries, but rather for, you know, something that can be used as is?
IRSI is an add-on. There is no problem with IRSI because it's not in SLE, so this is an easy example. I think what you're asking for is Kiemu.
Not necessarily, but you know, things like libvirt, libsecom, other things, you know, that
those
are not a leaf packet, but you know, somewhere in between the package dependencies.
You can submit that if it doesn't conflict with SLE, but for the packages you mentioned, they probably do conflict with packages in SUSE Linux Enterprise, so you cannot take them as is. But you could rename them. So we need to think about some easy way to do this, to somehow define some RPM macro that puts a prefix on the package or something like that, and then it doesn't install it as userbinqemu, but userbinqemu whatever, for example, then it would be acceptable, because then it would no longer override the SUSE Links Enterprise package. Is that what you were asking for?
Not exactly. So what I was more thinking about, if like the version of a package that is in factory is, as Frederick, I believe, also suggested, might be so new that it requires newer versions of packages than SLE 12 requires. And I'm just wondering whether in that case we would have side-by-side installed library versions with, you know, different SO names or so on of those dependencies as well, or whether that would rule out those leaf packages that depend on two new base system components.
As long as it's installable side-by-side, it should be fine. I mean, if the SUSE Links Enterprise has OpenSSL 1 and we have an OpenSSL 2 in this backports project, as long as they don't conflict, why not?
And then for the other aspect, so when we have the ERC package in your example in OpenSUSE, would then the person or group maintaining ERC would also be the same person that is submitting those maintenance requests to the backports project, or is that like two separate maintenance areas?
Ideally, they are the same. I mean, I would hope that the people that are interested in the backports project cooperate with those people that are interested in Tumbleweed. That would be the goal. So if security files a bug, for example, for ERC, then I hope that the OpenSUSE maintainer also cares for this backports project. It's also part of the reason why I picked the maintenance workflow, because then you usually use OSCM branch, and then you automatically also have the backports package checked out with your OpenSUSE updates. So I really hope for some cooperation there then.
And lastly, is this supposed to be demand-driven, as was suggested with this fate topic? Or is the goal to, at some point, you know, only through prioritization of requested packages, to arrive at having the full set of packages that we have in OpenSUSE available for those backports?
Right now, the idea is quality over quantity. So whoever is interested in having his package in backports should do it. And those that are not interested in it shouldn't be forced to do it. And there was also some idea to just take factory, compile all of it against the base, and just throw away those that conflict through this check. But I don't think that is fair. We should really involve the maintainers. So right now, in the starting phase at least, we want it on request. Only the maintainers that are interested, or where people are there that request this and the maintainer agrees, should submit the stuff there. Another question over there?
I just want to add that there's an open position for some guy who is managing, is talking with the upstream or the devil owners, the package owners, and he can, for one, he can take a request from third party, he can decide on his own to pull it back, or he can ask and discuss with OpenSUSE contributors how to integrate it and how to cooperate. So if anyone is interested in such a position, lots of talking, lots of packaging, there's an open position at the moment.
There's also room for lots of hacking, not just talking. Okay, no more questions? 3, 2, 1. Okay, thanks.